So, hello, welcome to GSoC office hours. After a long break, we continue our regular office hours. So last official office hours was on July 22nd. After that, we had a few retrospective meetings, which we didn't put in this agenda because they were separate meeting notes. And now we return back with focus on GSoC 2021. So we have several students and past GSoC participants on the call. And yeah, before we start, I would like to just quickly summarize what is the current state. So we finished GSoC 2020. There are a few pending action items left, like publishing the results blog post, etc. But overall, GSoC 2020 is over, and yeah, thanks to every participant. Now we focus on GSoC 2021. We intend to participate at the Jenkins project. At the same time, we are in early planning stage. So we still need to define the org admin team. We need to define mentor teams. We need to create project ideas. So what we have on our website at the moment is just a few initial project ideas, basically what we wrote over from the previous year, the ideas which we still have interest in and which haven't been worked on in GSoC 2020. And there will be more ideas in the future. So if you are a mentor interested in the project, or if you want to submit any new project idea, let us know, we can keep extending this list. So it's just an initial landing. And yeah, over the next few months, we will have much more details on the website. This year, GSoC will be slightly different from the previous years. So if you have seen the timeline, you can see that now there are two coding cycles. So GSoC is basically shorter than it used to be in previous years. It means that when we define the projects and project ideas, we will have to take it into account. And also, there will be some changes in the initial phases, but largely the GSoC format remains the same as before. So there will be still an application phase where every student is welcome to reach out to the projects, discuss project ideas, application drafts. And then once students submit their applications, we will have application review, which will happen internally within the organization. And after working with the other mentors and with Google, we will announce a final list of projects. It will happen on May 17th, so a bit later than it used to be before. And the community bonding will be over on June 7th. So basically, there will be still 3 weeks of community bonding as before. And there will be two coding phases. Both coding phases is approximately 1 month. So instead of 3 months of coding, basically you have 2 months of coding. The rest remains same as previous years. Okay. So that's what I wanted to tell about the plans and changes. Again, right now we are looking for participants, including org admins, mentors, and students, but we can start discussions now. And if you have any specific topics to discuss, if you have any questions, let's just discuss them so that we can start addressing these comments. And yeah, before that, do we have any potential mentor on the call? Or just potential students?
I will. I'll probably be a potential mentor this time.
So. Okay. So yeah, for you, it's a good time to think what would be a project you would be interested in terms of mentorship, in terms of project ideas, and we can discuss it in the chat. Also, there are guidelines about proposing project ideas, so you can start exploring this area. By the way, what is the project interesting to you or the area?
So actually, I was just looking at the project ideas. think remoting monitoring looks somewhat interesting, maybe. So I think, yeah, and let's see, maybe I can come up with a few ideas also.
Yep. So in previous years, we had from 20 to 30 project ideas. This year, well, let's see how many we have in total, but this list is definitely expected to grow. Okay. So, and from potential students, are there any questions, any topics you would like to discuss, or any questions specific to projects?
Yeah, hello.
Yeah.
Hello, everyone. Yeah, actually, I went through the project ideas, and one of the project caught my attention, that plugin installation manager tool. Mm-hmm. Like I went through that, and for that I saw the requirements, like what skills I need. So I was not that comfortable in Java, so I went through the, like, I'm learning Java at the moment, but I'm like now comfortable with it. But mm-hmm. there was a mention of Java configuration as a code, gcask in there.
Yeah,
yeah, like the how the Jenkins Docker image and configuration as code work in the skills to study and improve section, fourth one.
Mm-hmm.
The fourth point. Yeah, so I wanted like an heads up, like can you suggest me from where I should like learn about these things? Actually, I saw a talk on this. There was a talk by Nicholas Dalouf on Pragma or something, like mm-hmm. at Pragma conference on YouTube. I went through that, but like it is something which I'm not that comfortable at the moment. But like, do you have any suggestion or issues or anything like which will make me familiar with this topic? Because I think this is a very good project. Like package management, I like understand the importance of it, and I also went through the like theory of package management, but not yet that comfortable. But I'm going through it. So just wanted an reference or something to get more on this.
Yeah.
I went through this, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So you can start from documentation. We have some documentation for configuration as code plugin. And we also have a lot of demos specifying particular topics. So here you can find demos, and yeah, there is a lot of plugins. Usually when you start with this topic, my recommendation would be to just start from creating your Jenkins instance, maybe trying to configure it for your project, and then to move this configuration to configuration as code. So you could follow the guidelines. Here, for example, there is documentation about features, configuration export, which describes how to export configuration from existing instance. So once you create your instance, you can just try to convert it to configuration as code using these guidelines, using Docker image, so that it's also dockerized. Here you can find this information, how the Docker images operate. And if you need any specific demos, there is also, for example, there are multiple repositories which follow off approximately the same pattern. I will just show you my repository, demo Jenkins configuration as code. So this repository basically shows how to configure everything with Docker, Jcask. So you can just follow the example here.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, so I will put some links to the meeting notes. Mm-hmm. And while any other questions? Looks like not.
Actually, I have one more question. Just like not much of a question, but like, what's your suggestion on that thing? I was like setting up my own Jenkins instance, but I didn't want to install a lot of softwares and all that. So what I did was I tried with the Jenkins Docker image, and there was like to work with Jenkins plugin installation manager. There was one like reference guide about how to start a quick start section. There were huge like all the points were mentioned. Clone the project, run the test. There are several different lists of plugin. Mm-hmm. All those things were mentioned in the project's website page. So I was like, I just wanted to ask, should I go with the Docker image? Should I try running tests and trying this tool with a Docker image or with the Jenkins instance? I began with the Docker image, but I'm not that much comfortable with Docker. So what would you prefer? What would you suggest? What should I do in that? Should I go with a local instance or with Docker? Docker file, Docker image.
So in this case, Docker is rather an implementation detail. You can use the tool without Docker, and you can connect it to a local Jenkins instance. So personally, I would recommend to explore Docker, because Docker is a foundation technology which is good to know and which is widely used at the moment.
And Docker is also required for this project also, right? For plugin installation manager tool.
So it really depends on what would be your final proposal, because here we offer a project idea. So basically it's just our vision of what could be done and what would be the main tasks and priorities, but we don't define a project. It's student applicants who define what would they do. They submit a proposal. We make decision on that. So why Docker was there? You can see that Docker is mentioned multiple times because one of the main objectives for this project in 2020 was to integrate it into the official Docker images. You can see that this project is currently in the drafts because the description still needs to be updated. Current state that we already have it inside the Docker image. So if you go to Jenkins CI Docker, you can see that the tool is already embedded there. Just a second, that is plugin management. Sorry, it's in the documentation. Just don't see the navbar. Okay, so for pre-installing plugins, you can see that plugin installation manager is already in preview here. So the first step is done, but there are still issues we discovered during the evaluation. And also there are other use cases where the tool could be integrated. So it still remains relevant. At the same time, what would be the particular percentage of Docker work? It's yet to be seen and discussed in the proposal.
Okay, all right, thank you.
Yeah, thank you too. So yeah, you can definitely play with it without Docker. There is a lot of things which could be done without Docker. So if you go to plugin installation manager tool, for example, there is a number of open issues, actually not that many at the moment, but yeah, there are some defects which need to be fixed. There are also some enhancements which could be done. So you can play this without even touching Docker. And if you come up with a proposal which doesn't involve Docker and just improves the tool or integrates with other technology stack, I think it would be doable.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'll try.
Okay.
Okay, I'll see. Let's see.
Yeah, so we had Jenkins configuration as code SIG meeting today, and we discussed this tool a bit because there are still defects which impact adoption. And also we still have a problem of having multiple tools. So this is a GSoC 2019 project. It was created by Natasha Stapa, one of our students. Then it was improved over time. But we still have the main issue because this project was created to replace other plugin management tools. We have replaced it in the Docker image, but there are also many other plugin managers in Jenkins, and we still need to keep replacing them. And it's also something you could play with.
Okay. Our basic main goal of this project is if I try to simplify the whole like in crux, our main aim is to create a tool, for example, a package, basically a plugin manager, which will replace all kinds, every other plugin manager which exists at the moment in Jenkins to install plugins, right? In theory.
Yeah, in practice, of course, there are different obstacles which could prevent using this tool everywhere, but at least some usages could be replaced even now. For example, I'm maintainer of Jenkins File Runner. It's basically fast mode for Jenkins. So you can execute Jenkins pipeline in a container, and then this container shuts down. And here I also have a task for adopting plugin installation manager. There is definitely a pull request for that. So this is one of examples. It's not finished, but yeah, it basically replaces the internal plugin management logic by a plugin installation manager library. And you can see that the logic in the tool is quite short because it just supports a few use cases. But instead of that, the idea that here you would get full featured plugin manager. Yeah, same for the use cases. You can find a lot of plugin management code which could be improved.
Okay, I'll go through them then. Thank you.
Yeah, maybe. So you can probably go a bit back. So if you go to 2019, there are also project ideas. And here you can find the original problem statement where this tool was created. So it's here. Yeah, at that point we were doing project ideas in Google Doc, which also worked fine. So here you can find, for example, a list of existing implementations. And you can just go through these implementations, but your custom work package is still there. It hasn't been switched to the tool. Jenkins Evergreen, this project is deprecated at the moment, so it's probably not the most important thing. Jenkins File Runner is here, also other implementations which are still around. So you can explore the original scope and the original problem, which could be additional source of information for you. Well, at least it would help to understand why this tool exists and why you would like to adopt it.
Sure, then I'll go through them. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay. So, any other questions or comments? How we do this meeting? Basically, we hold it while there are questions. If there are no questions, we basically close the meeting earlier so that everybody gets more time. If there is no questions, again, we are just starting. And since we don't have other mentors and work admins on the call, we won't be discussing the project setup, I guess we will just keep working on that and synchronously. So if you haven't yet joined the mailing list, please do so, because we will be doing announcements there. And yeah, we will go to the developer mailing list soon in order to facilitate project ideas. Also, if you're looking for more project ideas, so this is just the list of what we moved, but you can find more project ideas, for example, for 2020 on four other years. Many ideas haven't been published for 2021, but they are still relevant. So for example, yeah, there are some ideas for Jenkins, for JenkinsX. Not all these projects have been completed during the previous phases, and even if they were completed, you may find some ways to extend that. So for example, if you're interested to work on pluggable storage, last year we finished external fingerprint storage, but there is still a big scope of different stories which we would need to deliver. Just a second. Pluggable storage. So for example, you can just navigate through pages and find these stories and problems which could be potentially a project idea, even if it's not listed at the moment. And if you have any idea what you would like to work on personally, just bring it up in the GitHub channel and we can discuss what we could do with it. Because yeah, well, if there is an idea, if there is an interested student, we can could ask around, maybe we could find mentors for this project idea. Any original project ideas are definitely our preference in the Jenkins organization.
Once again, I'll go again to about the automatic specification generator for Jenkins REST API. So I read about the idea. I've gone through Slacker and OpenAPI docs, but the project talks about the automation of the specification generator. So
yeah.
At one place I saw the documentation and there was a Swagger documentation on the Swagger Hub, but someone commented over there that it needs to be automated. So so right now I don't really have an idea about how we can do the automation of that. So
yeah,
any next pointers will be okay.
Mm-hmm. It's definitely something to explore. Also, just an additional sort of ideas for you. This year, we published the public Jenkins roadmap. So here you can find wider stories and initiatives on which the Jenkins community is working on. So here you can see that there are some items in preview, so which have been delivered, at least partially. Also, there are items which have been currently worked on and items which we want to handle in the near future or at some point. So if you are looking for a project idea, you could definitely take a look at these columns. So near term and future, because there you could make a proposal for your project. Also, some items in preview current, they could also be extended. You can find a particular area to work on. So you can just take a look at this page. And if you see something interesting to you and something which could fit the GSoC timeframe and GSoC basically project type, because GSoC is just about coding, then you can make a proposal for project ideas on the roadmap. I'm pretty sure that we could find mentors and interested stakeholders.
Thank you for that. I haven't gone through this, but my question was about this specifically about the specification generator. So,
okay, sorry for the two. Just so it's in 2021, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, specification generator. Sorry, I was probably answering the question. So here, again, the idea remained the same as in the previous year. So we would like to have generic specification for REST API or for a subset of REST API. For this project idea, you can find discussions in the mailing list, because last year we had students who were making proposals. topic for initial discussion. So you can find some additional source of inspiration just in, by going through the discussion. So for example, here you can see, check this thread as an example. Well, this thread is probably not the ideal one. There are just a few messages, but there are more threads which could help you. And here you can try to find them later. So just start by investigating REST APIs. If you have existing Jenkins instance, you can play with that, or you can just play, for example, with CI Jenkins IO. And, oh no, you cannot because our REST API is restricted. So most likely you won't be able to really call the endpoints, though some of the endpoints are accessible here. Yep. So API is blocked here. Yeah, maybe just on API or no, it's, it doesn't work. But you can find another Jenkins instance which is public and which exposes API. And you can really start writing simple code, for example, extension and et cetera, which could help with processing common stories.
Okay.
Yep. So open API basically would be your good starting point. Also for some code, you can see discussion links. You can also see how other things work. For example, there is it's plugin skeleton generate, I'm not sure what purpose it's here. But yeah, there are some components which already generate some data from Jenkins. So for example, if you go to configuration as code plugin, there are two features. One is schema generation, another one is documentation generation. And both of these features actually use the same indexing approach. They analyze code, analyze extensions, and generate the documentation. So for example, here, JSON schema. So you can explore the code inside, and, which could be a good source of information for you. Just a second. Okay. Sorry if the answer is too abstract. But yeah, it's probably an area to look into. And yeah, for example, next week, if you're interested, we can make a deeper dive because everybody, including me, need to restore context. So, is there anything else I could help with?
Yeah, sure. No, I'll go through it.
Also, have you already checked out Swagger Hub? Or whatever it's called these days?
Yeah, I have explored the Swagger Hub and Open API specification practice or some kind of like that.
Yeah.
For .NET so side, yeah, but yeah, for Java thing, I'll take it.
Okay, that's good.
And also Swagger Hub is paid now.
So, sorry?
Swagger Hub is paid version, no?
Mm-hmm.
So are we planning to use Swagger Hub or like something like Swagger Hub should be generated and every time like a REST API is something is changed and automatically documentation should be generated. Is that agenda for this project?
It can be an agenda because again, it's up to a student to submit the proposal. So for example, you explore this project, you define what would be interesting to you and what would be important. You discuss it with mentors. And after that, you come up with project scope definition. And for example, if you propose integration with Swagger Hub, if all mentors agree, why not? It's definitely something which could be useful. But while working on that, you still need to keep it in account, the project duration, because yeah, 2 months is not that long. And not everything can be delivered in 2 months. In this project, there will be likely a lot of foundation work just to get basic functionality running. So if you're able to also deliver integration with Swagger Hub, why not?
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, cool.
Okay. Anything else for today? Looks like not. So then thanks to everyone for your participation. And we will keep working and preparing to the project. Most likely we'll do official kickoff in December. But yeah, meanwhile, you're welcome to start exploring the projects or to propose your own project so that you have more information and we start preparing for the next year. Okay.
Yeah.
Thanks all. I'm not 100% sure whether we will have a meeting next week. But if there are any questions, please bring up them in the chat. So we have Jenkins GSoC Gitter. This chat is open 24/7. So if you have any question, just drop them there. And if there is an agenda, we will definitely host a meeting next week. And even if needed, we can have even more meetings. So it's quite unlikely in this early stage of the project. And thanks all. And the video will be available by tomorrow. So I will stop the recording and see you next week.